Hello, you beautiful bouquet of three-letter spooks. It's absolutely stirring to see you all here, may I just say. Let's go around the table. Let's introduce ourselves. Let's have a little icebreaker with an ice pick. We got Kyle from the NSA. What's up, Kyle? We got the Colonel from Who Took Johnny? Those who know will know. We have an ancient bull-headed Canaanite deity representing the NRO. And somebody, please, Carly or somebody, please tell me we have the raw kid livers around here to keep this thing sated for the duration of this meeting, because after all, spooks, Commandment 6.3 in the Neon Catholic Spook Bible, do not starve the Canaanite deities. That's a bad move, okay? All right. We have a cisgender millennial woman of color who struggles with generalized anxiety disorder representing the CIA.
I am perfectly made.
I am a cisgender millennial who's been diagnosed with generalized anxiety disorder.
Know your worth.
Command your space.
Mija, you're worth it. Mija, you're worth it.
I was a CIA for 3 years. Why cheated to sneak up to the wall? It reminds you of the glory of the American experiment.
And we even have Dale from the TSA for some reason. What's up, Dale? Hey, no need to bark disorienting orders about removing one's shoes and placing laptops out of bags to date, Dale. You're among friends, all right, buddy? Okay. All right, we have Donald from DARPA, Kay from IARPA, and Jill from ARPA-H. We have Becky from the FBI, another Becky from the DEA. Doing good work these days at the border with those fentanyl labs, eh, Beck? And yet another Becky from DHS. Three Beckys in the house today, friends, all right. And we can't forget Carl from Defense Intelligence Agency. Hello, Carl. Carly from the Geospatial Intelligence Agency, all right. And man, I tell you what, you want to spot a gnat from space? Geospatial's got you. All right, we got Carlisle from the Office of Naval Intelligence. So Carlisle, we got Captain Pokey from Army Intelligence, Billy Boy from Air Force Intelligence, William from Space Force Intelligence. It's remains to be seen whether that's an actual institution or not. But what's up, William? How's it going, buddy? We got Luke from the Treasury Department's OIA, Lucas from Coast Guard Intelligence. I guess they just commandeer speedboats and sell the drugs. That's what I'm assuming. What's up, Lucas? All right. And last but not least, we got Rex the Robot Dog representing the Department of Energy's Intelligence Agency, friends, which exists for some reason and which I'm sure is delivering fat checks to a bunch of people who do stuff that's important. We swear. All right. Oh, and me. Oh, I'm Gary from Border Patrol. What's up, friends? Yeah, I earned my stripe shooting kidlets in the face at Uvalde, but that's a tale for another time. All right, so why are we gathered here today anyway, friends? Well, the answer, my spooky comrades, is the poors. The plebs. The masses. The reason we're all gathered here today is the unwashed, stinking hordes. They are getting uppity. Very fucking uppity. I mean, we got rallies in public squares in support of Semites who are themselves anti-Semitic. Can you believe that now? We have Semites behaving anti-Semitically towards Semites in support of Semites. What the hell is happening in this country? I don't know. We got long-haired, mentally unhinged podcasters swinging around medieval weapons in the barrio. We have migrants talking to people of color about organizing for workers' rights and probably exchanging firearms too, for all we know. Fuck. You know, I thought we had already vanquished communism up in this cup, but apparently we have to go harder in the paint. Crack is so 90s, and fentanyl is just not quite cutting it either. Pun intended, right? Sure, a lot of people are dead and dying on the streets, but not enough. Becky too, or, DEA Becky, chime in for me here. What do we have cooking up to introduce into the inner cities these days? We gotta up our game.
Thanks, Gar. I'm going to begin by hearkening back to scripture. We really need to reconnect with our roots. Remember, comrades, commandment number one in the Neon Catholic Spook Bible, depopulate the pores or the pores depopulate us, okay? Depopulation is not just an agenda, Confederates. It's a lifestyle. It's a whole vibe. We need to flow with our efforts to poison the dirty hordes. We need to inject some feng shui into our nefarious black box projects and underground snuff labs. We've been back on our haunches for too long. We've been getting complacent. So, I've been in close contact with our good colleague Wang over in the Shanghai Research Chemical Development Prefecture, Sector Number 494, Precinct 82, District 9, Chapter 12, Verse 9, and he has been working on some truly nasty, truly exciting biomedical contrivances, okay? We've really been thinking outside the genealogical box. I told him, Wang, I'd rather you drill holes in the spines of 8,000 macaque monkeys and find nothing, rather than just crank out the usual, well, you know, crank. We needed to get subtle, and we have. Now, it did require the entire captive population of quote wild unquote pangolins in our Papua New Guinea exotic research fauna preserve, but as we all know, according to the Neon Catholic Spook Bible, God's creatures are literal shit put here by the Lord, in all capitals, Lord, for us to wipe our asses with, okay? So it's totally worth it. Y'all ever just close your eyes and just thank Moloch that it was we who, by sheer numbers, slippery infiltration, phallic breeding power, and innumerable betrayals and broken treaties, it was we who defeated the indigenous Americans during the protracted hellish slaughter of this blood-soaked land? We all gleefully call history and eat turkey to celebrate? I, for one...
Becky, get to the point. And get me Wang on the line. Stat! I want to hear this straight from the pangolin snout. Who's our geospatial wench around here, Carly? Carly, get us Wang on the holographic lecture projector. Becky, talk to me. Becky!
Sure, Gar. I know you're all excited to find out what we've done. Well, let's just say the pores are really gonna get it this time, comrades.
Damn it, Wang. Not now. Becky's about to spill the beans here. Fuck. Carly! Axe the goddamn hologram. Axe it. Wang, please. Becky, spill the beans.
Sure, Gar. Okay, so we basically just figured out a way to insert some crazy fucking research chemicals and mRNA genetic Play-Doh exosomes into approximately 83% of all products sold at Dollar Generals. So, like, anything you buy now at DG's, from kidney beans to bottled water to hairspray, is gonna make you alternately manic, sad, antisocial, high as a Georgia pine, possibly cause you to pass down some programmed genetic traits and susceptibilities to your offspring, and then obviously, you know, kill you, because brilliant, right? And so now we don't even have to work with Colombian drug cartels or deal with these street-level fucking CIA Jason middlemen. Oh, yes, cisgender millennial anxiety woman, yes? Mm-hmm. Yes, thank you, Miha. I just wanted to interject briefly. The CIA already low-key controls the Dollar General supply chain as part of Operation Organic Food Sahara, so this plant should go off without a hitch, girl. Let's do it.
Carly, damn it! Wang, please! Fuck! Carly, you know what? You know what, spook rats? Meeting adjourned. I'm already late for my PT, and I need to go soak my scalp in a brine of plebeian food anxiety tears real quick. I can feel that barely restrained desperation-induced hustle from here. Same time next month, my felicitous friends. We're going to be discussing our latest and greatest best practices for targeting developmentally disabled worshippers in mosques as part of Operation Bin Fucking Laden Kidding Me. IARPA has literally taken millions of taxpayer dollars, run them through a demonic inflation juicer endorsed by the Wall Street Journal as a recession relief smoothie, and produced some absolutely spectacular devices such as spy satellite connected smart hijabs, GPS connected smart carpets, and even MK Ultra enabled indoor palms that emit hypersonic hypnopedic terroristic suggestion stanzas. That's HHTSS, by the way. Great work there, Carlisle, too. Naval Intelligence represent. May your peep through life. What? That's some Ivy League secret fraternal innovation right there, all right? Some Geronimo skull shit. Fuck yeah. Makes you want to jerk off in a motherfucking coffin, am I right? Tax dollars hard at work, comrades. All right, now, let's go destabilize some low-income communities already, okay? Hands in, okay? On three. One, two. Merry fucking Christmas, you gaseous gremlins. That's right, I said Christmas, damn it. So what if it's after Christmas? We got some fucking long-haired podcaster procrastinating in lawful Nevada, spending time in fucking jacuzzis. I don't know what to tell you. Fucking A, it's Christmas every day as far as I'm concerned. We got State of Israel attacking Bethlehem on December fucking 25th, am I right? Christmas. Institutional fucking Christianity right now, woo! We're gonna bring on the fucking Armageddon, baby!
I am the queen!
We're gonna get the rapture back! Let's get it! Let's get that fucking rapture! Happy Holidays is softcore ritual porridge for the dilapidated pores!
I am the queen!
Happy Holidays is an attack on our Christmas! My white male Christmas!
I am the queen!
Dreaming of a white Christmas indeed!
Unjustifiably in a position that I'd rather not be in!
I, for one, cannot wait to celebrate the birth of our Lord in all capitals with some top-shelf Colombian avalanche up the snout, followed by guzzling copious amounts of the world's least enlightening drug, which, interestingly, we keep the most legal.
I am the queen!
And finally, by tearing open parcels made of plastic from China, who, by the way, we're going to be at war with by 2028, and who we are definitely going to lose to because, are you fucking kidding me, attempting to go to war with the nation state that serves as the spinal fluid for your supply chain? Are you fucking kidding me? It sounds crazy, right? Crazy like a depopulation fox, bitches. We'll be safe in our gated fallout-protected wilderness communities. Blah-ha-ha. Someone, Carly, get the Daft Punk around here. Let's get Daft Punk. One more time. Gonna celebrate.
The Macho Man Randy Savage is not happy.
Unjustifiably in a position that I'd rather not be in.
Outside interference here, I'm living in a nightmare. But the queen will rise to the top, oh yeah.
I am the queen.
Yeah, let me say it here. Let me say it out loud. The queen of the crop. I am the queen. I am the queen, yeah.
The cream of the crop.
I'm on my way. On balance, off balance, doesn't matter. Nobody does it better.
With three stores, north, south, and west, with three ranges, and with three programs, and here they are. Number one, if you'll join my range, I'll give you a 25 American-made automatic. If you join on another program, I'll give you an American-made Magnum. And if you join on another program, I'll give you both guns with holsters and ammunition. And why? You know why. Because I don't want to make any money, folks. I just love to sell guns.
Unjustifiably in a position.